Amen. Amen.
Let us now make our way to John, the first chapter, verse number 37.
Amen. All found? Amen. Amen.
John 1:37. God brought you here so he would get you introduced or reacquainted with John 1:37. To see am I in John country, how many ever read all 21 chapters through?
Oh, yeah. All
21 chapters. It's a blessing. When you read, you will succeed. John 1:37. The Bible says, and the two disciples heard him speak, and they followed Jesus. Two disciples heard him speak, and notice, and they followed Jesus. Many in America is traveling through a valley right now. One valley is the valley called Valley of Despair. People just don't know what to do with their lives. Another valley that people are traveling through is the Valley of Death. People, some died this morning. Some died on yesterday. Some died the day before that. People are in a valley of death. And David said, what about this valley? Do I walk through what? The valley of the shadow of death. I will feel no evil. Somebody is in a valley. God brought you here so you can get out of the valley. What valley? The valley of despair. The valley of death.
Yes, right. Come on, boy.
And then somebody right now, you are in the valley of decision. Many years ago, I was in the valley of despair. Many years ago, I was in the valley of death. Many years ago, I was in the valley of decision. But to get out of the valley of decision, one day my grandfather was preaching. And I got out of my seat. And I went down the aisles and I went forward. And I made it public. I came out of the closet and I made it publicly that I had decided to follow Jesus. My question is, as you look at 37 and they followed Jesus, my question is, have you decided to follow Jesus?
Well,
I'm talking on a subject for the next 5-6 minutes. I have decided to follow Jesus.
Amen.
One of the greatest decisions you can make.
Amen.
Right now is decide to follow Jesus. Come out of your closet, make it publicly that I have decided to follow Jesus. Make up your mind, I'm not going to play church no more. I have decided to follow Jesus. Make up your mind, I'm just not going to come to church, but I'm going to be the church. I have decided to follow Jesus. Why is it important that you decide to follow Jesus? There's a young man I know, 30 years old. He had a heart attack Friday. He got out of one car. He got in another car. And when he got in that car, he put some chemicals made by man in his mouth. And it wasn't long, a few seconds left, just after he put it in his mouth, his heart started messing up. Next thing you heard, he said, I can't breathe. One day, this stuff that man make, you keep putting it in you. Huh. You're going to say, I can't breathe. You know why? Amen. Because man is making this stuff.
Amen.
He said, I can't breathe, and he died on Friday. I don't know if he had made up his mind to follow Jesus. I hope he did. I hope he had confessed to Jesus, and I hope that he had got baptized for the remission of his sin. But the fact is, we're just down here temporary. You're going to leave this place called Earth. And we are going to leave the temporary. And we're headed to a place of eternity. That's why I have decided to follow Jesus. Because none of us know where death is. All you know is you got breath now. But 5 o'clock this evening, you may not have no breath. The old saying was what? Was what? Right. You're here today and gone tomorrow. But the new saying is, you're here today and you're gone today. Let's look at this. John 1, 37. I have decided to follow Jesus with my last 4 minutes. Now let's look at the text. And let's find out some men who decided to follow Jesus. According to 40, who decided to follow Jesus? His name is Andrew, right? Andrew decided to follow Jesus. In verse 40, who else decided to follow Jesus? Simon Peter decided to follow Jesus. Let's drop down to 43. Who else decided to follow Jesus? Philip. He decided to follow Jesus. Well, let's skip a verse. Let's skip 44 and get to 45. Who decided to follow Jesus?
Nathaniel.
So in the text, all the way from verse 37 to 51, we have 4 men who were going in life about their own business, but when they met Jesus, they made up their mind that I am going to follow Jesus. Andrew said, I'm going to follow Jesus. Verse 40. Simon Peter said, I'm going to follow Jesus. Philip said, I'm going to follow Jesus. Nathaniel said, I'm going to follow Jesus. And I'm wondering, have you made up your mind to follow Jesus? Now, this is the last Sunday in 2020. It's going to be gone in a few more seconds. And on this last Sunday, and because of this last Sunday, this is the reason you need to make up your mind to follow Jesus. Amen, Walt. Because you don't know if you're going to get another Sunday. God has given you this Sunday so you can make up your mind and say, I have decided to follow Jesus.
Amen.
There's a whole lot of folks here that have decided to follow Jesus, but not you. So put your name there and say, I'm going to follow Jesus. Now, why did John write this book? He wrote this book so you can make up your mind to follow Jesus. In John 20, verse 31, he says, many other things were written, but these were written, why? That you might believe. These were written so you can make up your mind and decide to follow Jesus. What's going on? The devil is in the fishing business.
Amen.
He put a bait before you.
All come right. On, Pastor.
Amen, Wall. Anybody know anything about fishing? Am I in fishing country?
Come on, Pastor.
You throw that bait out there and then you start
reeling
it in, amen, Wall.
That's that temptation.
The devil is reeling us in sin, amen, Wall. See, that's where sin began, amen, Wall. He will reel you in, amen, Wall.
Yeah.
And who is he reeling in? People who have not made up their mind that they are going to follow hear me this morning?
Amen, amen.
I'm talking about something called, I have decided to follow Jesus.
Amen, amen. Come on.
Notice the word, I have. You've got to speak for yourself. I have decided to follow Jesus. Amen. Wow.
Okay.
Andrew said, I've decided to follow Jesus.
That's what he said.
Amen.
Simon Peter said, I have decided to follow Jesus. Philip in our text says, I have decided to follow Jesus. Nathaniel said, I have decided to follow Jesus. Amen. Wow. Now let's look at Nathaniel in closing. Let's look at him for a few seconds. The Bible says, beginning at verse number 47. Well, let's back up to 46. Read 46. Come on, so we close.
Nathaniel said unto him, can there any good thing come out of Nazareth? Philip said unto him, come and see.
Nathaniel, just like a lot of you, Nathaniel was a negative man. Nathaniel said, well, I hear you, Philip, but look. We know about Nazareth.
That's right.
Can any good thing come out of Nazareth? And what did Philip say? He didn't force him. He didn't make him. What did he say?
Come and see.
He said, why don't you come
and see?
And why don't you see?
That's how he said.
Why don't you come and why don't you see? The Bible says, come, ye that are thirsty.
Uh-huh.
Come buy wine and milk without money and without price. God ain't charging you for salvation. He already paid the wages in red blood. Amen. Wow.
Already.
Salvation is already paid for. You've got to accept salvation.
Amen. Amen.
Let me tell you something. It's going to be pretty bad.
Amen.
On the other side. If this Sunday you don't make your mind up to follow Jesus.
Amen.
Now you can come to church all you want to, yeah, but it's a little more than just come to church. You've got to say, you got to put it online.
Amen. Come on, Pastor.
I'm not ashamed of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
I don't care who knows. I don't know. I don't care who knows my past.
Yeah.
I don't care who knows my present.
Yeah.
I'm in a struggle. But the one that's going to get me out the struggle, his name is the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Wow.
Amen.
I have decided
follow Jesus.
To follow Jesus.
Amen.
Let me do the roll call and we're going to quit. 47 says what? Come out.
47. And Jesus said something like that. Come to him and say to him, behold, here's one. An Israelite indeed, in whom is no God.
Notice what he said. Now when you decide to follow Jesus, can't be no guile in you.
Uh-huh.
The word guile means deceit, trickery. Acting like you fooling God. You cannot fool God. God know you're going in, and God know you're going out. Amen. Wow. You cannot fool God. Cannot be no guile. Cannot be no deceit.
Come on now.
The next verse says
that's
what? Come on
Nathaniel
now.
Then said unto him, which knowest thou me? Jesus answered, said to him, before that Philip called thee, when thou was under the fig tree, I saw you, man.
Did you hear what Nathaniel asked Jesus?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
How did you know me? Whence do you know me? You just met me. Well, he made you. That's why he knows you. He knows everything about you. He knows what time you got up this morning.
Amen.
And when you got up, he knows what you was up to. Amen. Wow.
Amen.
He knows what you was doing in the dark last night.
What you say?
I said he knows everything, Nathaniel. Amen. Wow. You ain't pulling the wool over God's head because he knows all. Amen. Wow. That's why I'm talking on a subject called I have decided to follow Jesus. You are to follow this man that knows everything. You know, that's pretty scary. A man that not only know what your hands going to do and what your feet going to do, but he know what your mind is thinking, amen, Wall.
All right.
Now, that's a man that you need to feel, amen, Wall. Now, the next verse is, what as we close? Come on, 50.
50? That's what you want?
Get 49. Jesus. Get 49.
49. They think answer and said unto him,
now, watch this.
Thou art the Son of God. Thou art the King of Israel. 50 said, Jesus answered and said unto him, because I said unto thee, I saw thee under the fig tree, believest thou that thou saw the greatest thing than these?
Now the Bible says, Nathanael did something some of you ain't done.
Mm-hmm.
He made a declarative. What was that declarative?
I son of God.
That you are the Son of God. And that's what the Father wants. Somebody who acknowledged his Son. Acknowledge what? That thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Who are you, Jesus? I'm the way, I'm the truth, I'm the life. You cannot get from this earth to heaven without me because I am the way. I'm not one of the ways, I'm the way. I'm not one of the lives, I'm the life. I'm not one of the truths flowing around. I am the truth, amen, wow. Have you made your mind up to follow Jesus? Let's call the row in close. Abraham made up his mind he was going to follow Jesus. There, Abraham in his room. Sarah, in the Old Testament, she had made up her mind that she was going to follow Jesus. Do we have an Abraham in this room? Do we have a Sarah in this room?
Yeah.
Do we have an Andrew in this room?
Yeah.
Do we have a Simon Peter in this room?
Yeah.
Do we have a Thomas in this room?
Yeah.
Do we have a Matthew in this room?
Yeah.
Do we have a Mark in this room?
Yeah.
Who do we have in this room? God brought you in this four-cornered room so you can get in your mind and declare that you need me. And without me, you're nothing. And without me, you're lost. I have decided to follow Jesus. When you say you decide to follow Jesus, you know what that means? You got to go public.
You got to go public. You got to give
it up. You got to come out the closet. And you got to let folk know who you on the dance floor with. You got to let them know while you're in your flow that I decided to follow Jesus.
Amen.
Hello?
Hello.
I decided
to follow Jesus.
Mm-hmm. If you see me doing a little drinking on the side, don't judge me. Get it together.
Amen.
But I recognize the only one that can deliver me is the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I tried to stay away from lying. I tried to stay away from stealing. Amen. Wow. I tried to stay away from a gossip, amen, but
yeah.
Jesus is the only one that can deliver me, and that's why you must make up your mind to follow Jesus. So we close with 2 Corinthians 6:2. Here's what it says. Now, N-O-W, now is the accepted time.
Now, right now.
Now is the day of salvation.
Amen.
Not tomorrow, now. Philip followed Jesus now. Nathanael followed him now. Simon Peter followed him now. And in closing, God wants you to follow him now.
Amen.
Are there any takers in the room?
Come on now.
Are there any takers?
Hallelujah.
Anybody in here not ashamed to follow Jesus?
Hallelujah.
Where's your opportunity? Here's your opportunity. To come and let this group know who is God talking to. He's talking to those who have never believed in Christ Jesus. He's talking about those who never repented of their sin. He's talking about those who never confessed him. He's talking about those who have never been baptized in Christ Jesus. Amen. Well, if you don't turn, you're going to what?
Burn.
You're going to burn. Amen. Well, and if you burn, you will earn. You're going to earn your burn. Amen, Wall. So don't earn your burn, amen, Wall. You don't want to burn with the devil. Now, remember the young man last Sunday after church, he gave his testimony about hell. He said he had a vision about hell. And it says one of the characteristics was the smell. The smell. I can still smell hell, amen, wall. I can still hear the howling. I can still see the crying. You don't want hell. Won't you come? Why is this mess so important? Because if you decide to follow Jesus, guess what the Father's going to do? He's going to take his pen out, and he's going to write your name in the book of life. Won't you come? Now, in our text, you better give it to me. You better give me the right answer. And our number one, who decided to follow Jesus? Give me one of the names.
Nathaniel, Peter.
Yes, sir. Come on.
Hello.
Come on.
Mark.
Mark. Give me some more.
John.
Abraham. John. Give me some
more.
Luke.
That's right. Come on. Give me some
more.
Matthew. Timothy. Amen. Give me some more. Give me some more.
Philip.
Philip. Give me some more.
Sarah.
Sarah.
Mark.
Give me some more.
Anthony.
Moses.
Moses. The Union.
The Hebrew.
All these people decided to follow Jesus. Now, the reason I'm going over this, don't you be left on the outside.
Come on, man.
Won't you come on the inside? That's the message.
Mm-hmm.
I have decided now. If you don't decide to follow Jesus, what's going to happen?
You're going
to
burn.
You're going to burn.
And you're gonna
if you do decide to follow Jesus, what's going to happen?
Oh, you're going to learn.
Amen. You're going to learn. You're going to learn that it's cool inside.
Yes.
So won't you come? Are you ready to come to Jesus?
Yes, sir.
I said, are you ready to come to Jesus? Because you don't know. You can be like that young man who put that chemical in his mouth.
Yeah.
The time he put it in his mouth, he couldn't breathe.
Come on, man.
The heart just went crazy. He said, I can't breathe.
No.
Like my man Floyd, Jaw. I can't breathe. Now, it's a terrible thing when you reach the point you can't breathe no more.
Amen.
That's terrible. When you can't breathe, you're grasping for air, you're trying, and you know you're dying, amen, well. That's terrible, amen, well. But you don't have to go out like that. You can go out being a child of God.
Amen.
Won't you come? The Spirit say come. The Bride say come. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. No one go with me. Still I will follow. No.